हेलो डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू उमा टॉक्स. एंड हियर आई एम विद अगेन स्टैंडर्ड 10th बायोलॉजी. ओके, द वेरी फर्स्ट चैप्टर, लाइफ प्रोसेसेस. वी हैव बीन डूइंग वेरी शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस. ओके, एंड लास्ट टाइम आई गेव यू ऑल डेफिनेशंस ऑल्सो. एंड टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन MCQs. अबाउट 3 वीडियोज आई हैव ऑलरेडी रिलीज. ओके, एंड टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द चैप्टर लाइफ प्रोसेस फॉर यू ऑल. आई होप दिस वीडियोज आर बींग यूजफुल फॉर यू. यू विल ओनली अंडरस्टैंड वेन यू सिट फॉर योर बोर्ड एग्जाम्स. इट विल बी रियली वेरी वेरी बेनिफिशियल चिल्ड्रेन. ओके, एंड प्लीज वॉच ऑल द वीडियोज, राइट ऑन द क्वेश्चंस. ओके, it is going to be. So let us start with short questions, life process. Okay, so the very first question is, match the organisms given in column 1 with the process given in column 2. Okay, so column 1 has got leech, amoeba, mushroom, algae. Okay, and column 2 has got holozoic nutrition, autotrophic, parasitic and saprophytic, means which organism undergoes which sort of nutrition. So leech undergoes parasitic nutrition. Okay, amoeba goes for holozoic. Okay, mushroom goes for saprophytic nutrition, and algae goes for autotrophic. Okay, because it is green and contains chlorophyll. Second question, name the following. The first one is mode of nutrition of cuscuta plant. Now that is what? Parasitic mode of nutrition. Okay, the second is first form of food substance produced during photosynthesis, that is glucose. Third, organism which live on or inside the body of another organism and depends on it for food, parasites. And fourth, small openings present on leaf surface, that is stomata. Okay, when do the desert plants take up CO2 and perform photosynthesis? Desert plants take up carbon dioxide during night time, and carbon dioxide is stored in the form of an intermediate and during daytime in presence of sunlight energy. Okay, so they perform photosynthesis. This method is called CAM photosynthesis because during the daytime their stomata remains closed to avoid water loss due to transpiration process. Okay, so now we come to fourth question. What are the adaptations of a leaf for photosynthesis? Now, some of the adaptations are there. The first one, chloroplasts are concentrated more on the upper surface of the leaf than the lower surface. Second, leaves provide large surface area for maximum absorption of sunlight energy. Third, more stomata are present on lower surface of leaves so that more carbon dioxide can enter for efficient photosynthesis. Fourth is, leaves are arranged at right angles to the light source so that they can get better sunlight. Now, fifth question, what would happen to the rate of photosynthesis in the following situations? First, cloudy days, stomata gets blocked due to dust. Second and third, good manuring in the area, means what will happen to the rate of photosynthesis, means speed. So on cloudy days, there is no or minimum sunlight, so rate of photosynthesis decreases. And if stomata are blocked due to dust, it will cause problem in gaseous exchange. Okay, hence again the rate of photosynthesis will decrease. And third is good manuring, means providing manures. Okay, that will ensure good supply of minerals. Hence photosynthesis rate will increase. Okay, so now we move to sixth question. So coming to sixth question is here. Okay, so what criteria do we use to decide whether something is alive? That is movement and growth. The description is given, children. You can see all living organisms show movement, like running, walking. Okay, they show all they all show such growth and require energy for cell repair and replacement. Second is nutrition. They require food to derive energy. Respiration, they inhale oxygen to break down glucose to release energy. Reproduction, to give birth to new ones. Excretion, to eliminate waste products in the form of urine, feces from their body. Okay. Seventh is, what are outside raw materials used by an organism? So these are the outside. First carbon dioxide, water and mineral nutrients needed for autotrophic plants. Then organic nutrients are required by heterotrophic organisms. And then oxygen is used for respiration by both autotrophs and heterotrophs for oxidation of glucose to release chemical energy in the form of ATP. Eighth question. What process would you consider essential for maintaining life? That is, processes like nutrition, respiration, transportation, excretion, control and coordination, reproduction, etc. are considered essential for maintaining life. Okay. Ninth, where do plants get each of the raw materials required for photosynthesis? That is, CO2, they get it, plants take CO2 from the air. We exhale out carbon dioxide. That is in the air and that is taken up by the plants through the stomata. Okay. And stomata are present in the leaves. Aquatic plants get CO2 found dissolved in water. Water ka plants take in water from the soil through roots. And third, sunlight energy. It is trapped by chlorophyll present in the chloroplast of leaves. Fourth is chlorophyll. It is present in chloroplasts which are found in green portions of the plant like leaves. Now, tenth. What are the necessary conditions for autotrophic nutrition and what are its byproducts? Now, the necessary conditions for autotrophic nutrition are CO2, water, sunlight, energy, chlorophyll, and the byproducts are water and oxygen. How do guard cells regulate opening and closing of stomatal pores? Okay, children, these questions with answers will also help you to understand that what sort of answers should be written for a particular question. Okay, so coming to guard cells are kidney-shaped cells which contain thicker inner walls, okay, and thin outer chloroplasts in them due to increase in solute concentration inside the guard cells. Water from subsidiary cells rushes inside by osmosis. Okay, the process of osmosis, movement from high concentration to low concentration. Okay, for liquids. As a result, guard cell swells up and the thin outer wall bulges out and thick inner wall is pulled inside. The stomata opens. And during night time, reverse happens. Water rushes out from the... Is it clear? I hope it's clearer, children, from the guard cells and they become flaccid, closing the stomatal pore. Thus, tugor pressure of guard cells helps in closing and opening of stomata. Okay, so this is open stomata diagram. Okay, open stomata diagram. You can see the guard cells. You can see vacuole, nucleus. Okay, stoma, cell wall, chloroplast. And this is a closed stomata. Okay. The guard cells are shrunken. So this is up till question 11. Now let us move to question number 12. So coming to 12th, okay, what would happen if green plants disappear from earth? Okay, green plants are autotrophs, that is, they prepare their own food, and all herbivores and carnivores depend directly or indirectly on green plants for the food. Herbivores directly eat plants, and if green plants would not be there, they will die of starvation. Similarly, carnivores eat herbivores, and if herbivores will die, so naturally carnivores will also die. Green plants release oxygen to atmosphere by photosynthesis, which is a life supporting gas. Excuse me. So in short, we can say without green plants there may not be any chance for existence of living things. 13th, what is emulsification and which substance brings about this process? The process of breaking down of large fat globules into smaller droplets is called emulsification, and this process is carried out by bile secreted from liver and small intestine. 14th, what will happen if mucus is not secreted by the gastric glands? Gastric glands present in stomach secrete HCl, mucus and digestive enzymes, pepsin. The function of mucus is to protect the inner lining of stomach from the corrosive action of HCl acid and also from the action of digestive enzymes, pepsin. If mucus will not be secreted by gastric glands, then HCl will damage the inner lining of stomach, which may lead to ulcers. Okay, children, So as I'm making these videos, it is going to be useful for you. And for those who have not subscribed, I've been telling you every time, do subscribe. I'm going to definitely, even before your exams, I'm going to post some probable questions, जो जिसके chances हैं आने का, ये तो preparation है. And for all the chapters, I'm going to do. So do share it and again like it. Okay, put your comments. That is really going to boost me up. Okay, so up till 15 question we'll do. Name any three glands associated with digestion in humans and write the names of enzymes secreted by them. That is glands, salivary glands. Okay, the enzyme is salivary amylase, gastric glands, pepsin, pancreatic glands, trypsin, lipase and pancreatic amylase. So over here I finish up till 15. In my next video, I'll continue with further. Okay, so hope you are writing it. And again, what to say, do like it. And thank you, children. Thank you for watching. Thank you so much. Take care.